So today we are gonna talk about the five books that have the biggest impact on my life. Okay, so this story goes back to when I was still in college. I read an article that an average CEO of a Fortune 500 company reads almost about 60 books a year. Then I thought that I'm not even near a CEO and I was just a student who was pursuing culinary and wants to become a chef someday. But there was a fire in my heart and I was hungry for knowledge. So I started to read. At first, I really read very little, like 15 minutes a day. But now, today, I can see the results of the reading and it helped me along the way till today. But honestly though, I have read a lot of good books and bad ones too. But here are the five books for you to start reading. The Total Money Makeover. It shows you that how to stop accepting debt as a normal and eliminate it forever in small increments and build the financial future that you deserve in 7 steps. There are tons of books out there supposedly teach you how to become a millionaire, and Dave Ramsey talked about the things that we mostly ignore about money, and he said that we buy things that we don't need with money. And we don't have to impress people that we don't like. Here is three things that's really caught my attention. Put away $1,000 in an emergency fund and start paying your own debts, beginning with the smallest investment, and grow your emergency fund until you have a 3 months buffer at least. On the next one is Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. Think and Grow Rich is a collection of 13 most common habits of wealthy and successful people. The author studied and took interviews with over 500 successful individuals over the course of 20 years. So if the intelligent investor, that book is the Bible of investing, then Think and Grow Rich is the Bible for successful people in general. I have read this book many times whenever I lack my clarity about the goals in life. This book not only inspire but instruct how to be rich. Three little notes on this book will be used autosuggestion to build an unshakable belief in yourself and be stubborn and always stick to your decision. Join a mastermind group to cut the learning curve. Next up is Wings of Fire by APJ Abdul Kalam, the 11th president of India. Wings of Fire is an autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam, covering his early life and his work in Indian space research and missiles program. So it is the story of a boy from a humble background who went on to become a key player in Indian space and research and missile programs and later became the president of India. The story left a mark on me that a boy who came from such a humble beginning became the nation's hero and how he did it. That is written in the book, and I would highly recommend this one book. On his quote, to succeed in life and achieve result, you must understand and master three mighty forces: desire, belief, and expectation. The next one is a great one. It's an autobiography of Nelson Mandela called The Long Walk to Freedom. So in this book, Nelson Mandela told us stories from his childhood days, his education, and how a lawyer can become a spy and the president of the Republic of South Africa. I will never forget that how a person like Nelson Mandela sacrificed his family and friends in 27 years of prison just so his nation gets independence and equality for all. The story itself was very compelling, the time that he spent in jail, and showed us a character that was unshakable. It was a useful reminder that all men, even the most seemingly cold-blooded, have a core of decency that in their heart is touched. They are capable of changing. Next is Kitchen Confidential by Anthony Bourdain. Kitchen Confidential is an insider look into the underbelly of the culinary world. Remember, you can read this book even if you are not a chef or a cook or just a foodie. It's really worth it. Bourdain showed us that what it looked like to work in the front lines of the restaurant business. As a memoir, It's also a personal story of Bourdain's experiences and how he became a chef from a restaurant line cook. He was not just only a chef, but he was also a storyteller who visited so many different places in a lot of different countries and shared his experience about their food culture. And what I really digest from this book is it is really timeless and valuable to me. He was looking for cooks who had a character. He famously said in the book, and I quote, that skill can be taught, but character either you have or you don't have. By the way, that was just a little bit of what I think is really valuable for me. And each and every book covers a very different ways of looking at our lives, and it can give us a new ways to get ahead in life. And feel free to follow me on Instagram, and do not forget to comment down below about your favorite book and in a what way it helped you, and I would love to hear from you. See you until next time.